I was always a good student, and I always worked hard.
Yeah, you really do, yeah.
Donald Trump. So many things have been said about the man, who, of course, is the former president of the United States. Although many have dissenting ideas about his business practices or his time at the White House, one thing is for sure, the man is rich. He's living a life and enjoying pleasures that most of us can only dream about. In this video, we're going to talk about Donald Trump's lifestyle, net worth, and what he spends his money on. But before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss any of the new videos that we post. It is certainly good to be the Donald. He makes money, even in his sleep. He once described himself as someone really rich and really good at making money. Guess we can't argue with that. Say what you will about the man, but he knows his money. He may have a few unsuccessful ventures here and there, but for the most part, he's raking in profits. He got his financial savvy from his father, who started a million-dollar residential real estate business in Queens and Brooklyn. Donald Trump's first project was the Commodore Hotel. He partnered with the Hyatt Organization in 1976, to buy it in for an undisclosed price. Fast forward to 2021, and he's got plenty of properties. He may claim to be a real estate mogul, but the bulk of his net worth comes from his own personal brand. The Trump Organization began to license the Trump name and other companies in the 1980s. Like his father, he has a reputation of saving every penny possible. He told Reuters that he renegotiates contracts 10% to 15% of the time. Donald Trump has refused to publicly disclose his tax returns. Although tax returns won't determine his net worth, this has made it a challenge to determine his actual income, so we can rely on estimates. For now, he has a few properties that were listed as worth more than $50 million, but these estimates were unaudited, self-reported, and often clashed with the Trump Organization's reports to state and other local officials. Approximations from outlets such as Forbes give us probably the closest thing we get to his net worth. In April 2020, Forbes put Trump's net worth at a little over $2 billion, with a sudden drop in value due to the global health situation. While the bulk of his assets lie in his commercial real estate holdings, he has interests in a few industries. Well, so we ask, how does someone like him spend his moolah? Follow us and we get down to the nitty-gritty of his finances. Let's start with his alimony payments to first wife, Ivana Trump. Donald and Ivana's tumultuous divorce didn't wipe out his bank account, but it sure put a dent in it. Not only did Ivana get to keep the couple's 45-room Greenwich mansion, she also got a $10 million settlement, an annual alimony of $350,000, an apartment in Trump Plaza, and $300,000 a year in child support. There was also the alleged $130,000 paid to Stormy Daniels to shut her up. Remember the controversy that happened prior to the 2016 election? A woman named Stormy Daniels came forward to share her sexual encounters with Donald Trump to the world. Although she had been coy about the truth of her affair with Trump, there were reports that she was allegedly paid a huge sum of money to keep her quiet. He spent $66 million for his presidential campaign. Trump raised $339 for the 2016 election, but he spent $66 million from his own pocket to fund his campaign. This is short of what he openly bragged to spend, which is $100 million. He likes to wear expensive suits. Like Donald Trump's suits, they cost him a pretty penny at more than $5,000 a piece. The Brioni is his favorite suit, and it's highly likely he's paying more for his custom shirts as well as alterations. Interested to buy a basic t-shirt from them? You better have $300 to spend on it. He travels in a Sikorsky S-76 helicopter. When you look at Trump's possessions, you'll surely be able to tell that he loves gold. He travels in style in his Sikorsky S-76 with interiors redesigned by Eric Roth to cater to all his needs and wants. It's decked out in 24-karat gold, and the additional cost of the renovation alone is said to have cost an estimated amount of $750,000. We could buy plenty of automobiles with that amount of money. One or two RAV4s anyway. Another member of his inevitable fleet is the Trump emblazoned Boeing 757. It is covered in dark wood and ivory leather, boasts two bedrooms, and a 57-inch flat-screen TV. What's the most expensive feature on the plane? It might just be the 24-karat gold faucets or the 24-karat gold seatbelt buckles. You ever have a couple $1,000 save your life? He also owns a Cessna jet. Trump just loves to fly, so he had bought himself a Cessna jet. He reportedly bought it for $15.3 million. Collectively, he has a 3-helicopter, 2-airplane fleet that is valued at $32 million. Everyone knows he owns Trump Tower. The man is clearly obsessed with bling and everything that glitters. His penthouse in New York City has crown moldings and lamps in 24-karat gold. He even has drinking glasses rimmed with 24-karat gold. goal too. Well, you know what they say, if you got it, flaunt it. A slew of other real estate properties. Trump has two homes in Sterling, Virginia, which are collectively worth $1.5 million. He also has three Palm Beach homes worth a collective $25 million. His 39,000 square foot mansion in Bedford, New York is reportedly worth a cool $24 million. If he wants sunnier climates, he can also go to his private island home in St. Martin, Le Chateau des Palmiers. It's worth $13 million. Speaking of real estate properties, we must include his Mar-a-Lago estate. Trump purchased the Palm Beach estate in 1985 and aptly named it the Winter White House. The 20-acre estate then became a private club in 1995. Of course, Trump had to make some renovations to the 128-room structure. One of its highlights is the 20,000-square-foot ballroom that's covered in $7 million worth of gold leaf. The beach escape's number of rooms has been cut down to 58, but it now boasts of added features such as 12 fireplaces, 33 bathrooms, 3 bomb shelters. 3 bomb shelters? Safety. The most bomb sheltery bomb shelters. Oh, it's also written in his divorce settlement with Ivana that Mar-a-Lago is hers for a month every year. She gets a cut of that bomb shelter. For someone who doesn't like boats, Trump spent $30 million on a yacht. The Trump Princess is the name of one of Trump's most prized possessions. The yacht was purchased back in the late 80s and features 100 cabins and accommodates a crew of 52. At the time of the purchase, the yacht was considered top of the line. It has cabin walls covered in Cameos leather and bird's eye maple. The bathrooms are made of onyx and also has a helipad. Trump may be out in the ocean, but he's not giving up any comforts he enjoys every single day. Mercy. Of course, someone like Trump must also have a car collection that would make our jaws drop. He reportedly owns a vintage Rolls-Royce Silver and Rolls-Royce Phantom, and both start at $500,000 each. He also bought the former First Lady an SLR McLaren that cost $455,000. Other vehicles in his garage include a Mercedes-Benz 3600, a Maybach, and a Ferrari. He previously owned a blue 1997 Lamborghini Diablo, a 1994 Cadillac Lante, and a heavily armed super limo, which was christened Cadillac One. The bulletproof car cost more than $1.5 million to make. His love for gold is a well-known fact. By now, you may have already noticed that Trump likes gold very much. If he did, he wouldn't decorate his planes, cars, and real estate properties with it. Though his Bitcoin investment may remain a guessing game, it's a fact that he once accepted a $160,000 security deposit in the form of gold bullion. In an interview with GQ in 2016, he said, "Bringing back the gold standard would be very hard to do, but boy, would it be wonderful. We'd have a standard on which to base our money." Melina also has a taste for high fashion. Having been a model once and being married to one of the richest people in the world, you can also expect Trump's wife, Melina, to have expensive taste. She's been spotted wearing a Givenchy dress that costs at least $2,000, as well as a Monique Lhuillier sequin gown that has a price tag of $7,995. Whoa, that's a lot more than a regular person's monthly salary. There was also a time when she stepped out wearing a Dolce & Gabbana jacket that has a price tag of, drumroll please, $52,000. That's more than what most people make in a year. Come on! His son, Baron Trump, attends a school that charges $40,000 a year. It sure is good to be one of the Trumps. Trump's youngest son, Baron, once attended Columbia Grammar and Preparatory School. He currently goes to St. Andrew's Episcopal School in Maryland. What do both schools have in common? Their fees cost $40,000 a year. Of course, we can't end this video without talking about the absurd sums of money spent on his coif. When it comes to Trump, one of the things which people were very interested was his hair. Does he or doesn't he wear a wig? There's been so much talk about his orange-tinted fairy floss that for once, people would just like to hear it straight from him. Although we don't have the exact number of his coif expenses, one insider did come forward to say that Trump spends as much as $60,000 a year on his hair. The procedure in question is rumored to be the microcylinder intervention. The non-surgical technique claims to add length and thickness to balding hair. If you had Donald Trump's money, what would you spend it on? Orange hair? Let us know in the comment section. Stay safe, and we'll see you around.